سيدنا محمد النبي الطاهر الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين. أما بعد، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة والفضيلة، أيها الحضور الكريم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته في صبيحة هذا اليوم الثاني من مؤتمر AAOIFI البنك الدولي في نسخته 12. نبدأ إن شاء الله تعالى على بركة الله في هذه الجلسة بدعوة سعادة الأستاذ عبد المحسن الفارس، وسعادة الأستاذ خالد فقيه، وسعادة الأستاذ أيمن سجيني، وسعادة الأستاذ إياد العسلي، وسعادة الأستاذ سليمان الحارثي بالتفضل إلى الاعتقال المنصة. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Welcome to the third session of this annual conference on Islamic banking and finance. And I have 70 minutes for this panel discussion, and we have five very distinguished panelists who represent the financial services industry, from the banks and financial institutions. And I also want to have participation from the floor, because there are some very distinguished people in the audience and we would like to listen to them. Because this session is going to focus on standardization and what are the costs and the benefits of standardization. Because you have national standards, you have AAOIFI standards, you have IFSP standards, corporate governance, on risk management, on accounting, and then you have the Sharia standards also. Whether this is adding to the cost of Islamic banking in competition to international banking. And there cannot be anybody more qualified to talk about these than the bankers and the practitioners themselves. And we hope that this interactive session will give some ideas to the standard-setting bodies as to what the views and opinions of the practitioners are in order to absorb and reduce this cost and make them more competitive. And that is the purpose of this. And we would like to have five questions. What is the role of the standards in promoting qualitative growth of enterprises and industry? If enterprises and industry do not grow, then the banking doesn't grow at all. They are related to that. The second is whether the standardization raises the efficiency of Islamic banking and the credibility of the institutions which are engaged in this particular endeavor. What is the need for the regulators to adopt these standards, both the supervisors and the regulators? The fourth question is, what are the practical challenges of standardization from the point of view of the leaders of financial institutions? And that is why we have a galaxy of very distinguished people, but they will also try to relate it to the larger picture. And what are the factors and opportunities which help in standardizing the industry? And how does it improve the rationalization of the expenditures? Because after all, it is the bottom line. If the cost income ratios of the financial institutions, Islamic banking, are higher than those of conventional, then they are at a comparative disadvantage. So these are the topics which we would like to discuss in this panel. And without much ado, I have great pleasure in inviting His Excellency, Mr. Abdul Mohsin Al-Faris, who is the CEO of Al-Inwa Bank in Saudi Arabia, to start. We have 10 minutes. Each panelist is 10 minutes.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salam ala ashraf al-anbiya wa al-mursaleen. نبينا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته. صباح الخير. اسمحوا لي ابتداء ان اشكر AAOIFI على دعوة وعلى هذا المؤتمر بحقيقة الذي حظى بنقطة كبيرة جدا يوم الأمس، ولعل الكلمات الافتتاحية هو اللقاء مع معالي الأخ الكبير الدكتور أحمد محمد علي فيها من المدخلات الكبيرة حاليا، وأنا طلبت من الدكتور حامد فعلا مراجعة